Hey, what's going on, guys? Radio Graffiti here, and today I want to talk to you guys about Spider-Man 2, the original Spider-Man 2, from Sam Raimi back in 2004. No Way Home is coming out in December, so I thought, you know, why not go ahead and take a look at all the past Spider-Man movies leading up to it. I've already done Spider-Man 1, so if you haven't seen that already, make sure you go check it out. I'll leave a link in the description down below. But this time, we're going to be talking about Spider-Man 2, the best Spider-Man movie of all time, and one of the greatest superhero movies ever made. Some of the people still consider it to this day to be the best superhero movie of all time. I don't think it's that amazing, I wouldn't go that far, but it's definitely worth being brought up. When I say the best Spider-Man movie, the only competition it really has is Into the Spider-Verse. That's a good one as well, but personally for me, Spider-Man 2 is just the best Spider-Man movie, and I'll be going over why right now. The whole movie is basically just exploring Peter Parker and just how much it really sucks to be a superhero. This is one of the first superhero movies that explores just how much being a superhero would actually suck in real life. His best friend hates him, he gets fired from his pizza job, he has to fight his mentor, Dr. Octopus. He's broke as fuck, he's on the verge of failing his class. His crush, Mary Jane, which I think he needs to get over, by the way, she's a complete thought and for the streets. Well, she's getting married, to nobody's surprise, and of course it's some random dude we never heard of, because this Mary Jane is a complete whore. And not to mention, he loses his powers in this movie, so Spider-Man basically has nothing good going for him this entire film. His life is complete shit, and that's what makes this movie so entertaining, is that it really focuses on Peter as a character, which is something a lot of people feel like the MCU Spider-Man movies have really failed to achieve is something as deep and meaningful as what this movie is right here. Just being able to focus on Peter Parker as a character is just so fascinating. He really feels like an actual person. He doesn't feel like, oh yeah, I'm the goody two-shoes that's gonna save the day. So I really appreciate them focusing so much time on Peter Parker and making it entertaining and interesting. It's not just completely boring. You're just ready for it to get over with so they can put on the Spider-Man outfit. It would've been so easy for them to just say, okay, we're gonna focus on Peter, and then whole movie you're just waiting for him just to throw on the Spider-Man outfit again. Kind of like what happened with The Dark Knight Rises and Iron Man 3. They focus more on the actual characters, like Bruce Wayne and Tony Stark, rather than Batman and Iron Man. Which is kind of the fault of the movie. It didn't work in its advantage like this movie does. They should take notes from what this movie did. Now, besides that, what else did I really love about this film? Well, I love how it's not afraid to kind of go above and beyond the PG-13 rating. I mean, look at the scene with Doc Ock when he's knocked out and all the doctors are ready to operate on him, and it's just completely fucking terrifying for a PG-13 film. Just the screams of horror as they're being taken out by these arms while the man's unconscious is just absolutely terrifying. The fact that this isn't a PG-13 Spider-Man movie that is really aimed for like kids and teenagers. Sam Raimi knows that teenagers and kids are gonna be seeing this. So yeah, I liked how it wasn't afraid to be mature. They weren't trying to just appeal to kids the whole time, which the movie is pretty cheesy still. It has the same tone as the first one. It's not trying to be too serious. Got about the same tone. It's just a goofy comic book, golly gee kind of tone throughout the film. And that's perfectly fine. That's what Sam Raimi's going for. I also have to give a shout out to J.K. Simmons as J. Jonah Jameson. He continues to be one of the best supporting characters in any comic book movie. This guy is absolutely entertaining as hell. Every time he gets a scene, he's just so hilarious and funny. He just catches your attention. Like, it would have been so easy for them to focus on JJ for a little bit. Do you just be bored and be like, can we get rid of this idiot already so we can get back to Spider-Man? But no. He's a whole nother level of entertaining and brings something new to the film. I also really enjoy the scene where Peter Parker tells Aunt May about the truth of where he was when Uncle Ben died. It could have been really easy for her to just be like, oh, I accept you, Peter. But in this movie, she doesn't say anything. She just stands up and just looks at him in disappointment and just walks away, clearly showing her disapproval for what's happened, which is understandable. But I really like that they didn't take the easy way out, which they easily could have in that scene. But besides that, I mean, the music is fucking fantastic, of course. It's just as good as it was in the first film. Danny Elfman really knew what he was doing here. And of course, the costume designs are all on point, especially Spider-Man. It looks the same as the first one, but somehow it actually looks better. Like, I don't know, something about the colors and the blue, it looks like darker. And of course, all the actors do a great job. The cinematography is absolutely amazing. You gotta love that scene in the movie where Spider-Man comes back and Spider-Man kicks through the newspaper and then he's swinging towards Doc Ock, and then you see the reflection in Doc Ock's glasses as the camera pans out to him right before they start their fight with the train, which is one of the most iconic sequences in any comic book film ever. The train sequence between Dr. Octopus and Spider-Man, rightfully so. If I had any complaints at all about the film, I'd have to say Harry Osborn's being kind of a little bitch. He's pissed off at Peter because someone he takes pictures of supposedly killed his father, which he doesn't know for a fact. He has seen him bring him in. He doesn't have any confirmation at all that he actually killed him. He doesn't know what happened. So he kind of just blindly hates Spider-Man just because of ignorance. Like, he has no idea what happened. For all he knows, his father could have gotten hit by a fucking bus, and Spider-Man was just happened to be in the neighborhood, so he dropped him off. I don't see why he'd be mad at Peter, just because he takes pictures of him. He's like, oh, well, fuck you, Peter. We're no longer best friends anymore, because you take pictures of a guy who I believe killed my father. And also, yeah, like I said, Mary Jane's just kind of a hoe. She's not as bad as she was in the first movie. In the first movie, she was really thotting it up. She was a real hot girl. But in this one, she's only messing with some astronaut guy. I've seen this movie multiple times. I've watched it probably hundreds of times since I was a damn kid. I love this movie. I watched it so many times. But yeah, I still can't tell you what the hell the astronaut's name is in this film. What an absolute bland character. Yeah, it kind of comes out of nowhere and it's like, oh, I'm marrying Mary Jane, which is fine. We don't need a fucking subplot with the guy. Because he has no purpose in the story at all besides kind of draw Mary Jane away from Peter, which is kind of what just happened in the first movie too. But they finally get together in this film at the very end. But yeah, guys, this movie's definitely a classic. It's got a still huge following to this day, which is crazy because this movie came out in like 2004 and people still are just quoting it like no tomorrow. There's been so many memes and videos about this movie. There's literally like probably hundreds of fucking Raimi Trilogy fan accounts that just constantly meme these movies. Speaking of how old this movie is, the visual effects still look great to this day. I know they did a mix of visual effects with practical, which I enjoy. I like when movies use more practical than rely on effects, because practical is going to look better in the future. And on Doc Ock, like Doc Ock's arms, for example, they still look great. They still hold up to this day. They still don't look fake. They easily could have just used a whole bunch of CGI on it and it would have looked completely terrible to this day. This movie came out 18 years ago. Holy fuck, I'm getting old. But yeah, guys, what do you guys think about Spider-Man 2? Do you think it still lives up to the hype of being one of the greatest comic book movies ever made? And do you think it's the best Spider-Man movie of all time? If not, tell me what your favorite is. I'm curious to know. It's actually kind of a hot topic of what everyone's favorite Spider-Man movie is, and that goes to show you the quality of these films. When everyone has their own favorite. I've seen people say some of the Holland movies were their favorite. I've seen people say Spider-Man 1 is their favorite as well, or Into the Spider-Verse. But we'll see if No Way Home is able to top all of those in December. In the meantime, let's go over the ones we have had. And I'll see you guys next time when I do my Spider-Man 3 review. Catch you guys then.